Dr. Davis, Mr. Angela, I've wanted you to know this for 45 years.
Oh, Mary, what do you think?
Okay. 45 years ago, you were on the run, I guess, staying away from the FBI. I was in Vietnam, and there were a whole bunch of us who were pulling for you over there. And I hope on some level at that time you knew that. I'm glad we're both here, and it's great to see you.
Let me say how happy I am to conclude this gathering on that note, particularly since I began by talking about the need to contest the historical amnesia which is inflicted on us. So thank you very much. Yes, I was aware. I received many letters from GIs in Vietnam. I had actually been, before I was arrested, I had actually been involved in the GI movement in California. So I had that connection. And I was running from the FBI in 1970.
And I was running from the NPA. So.
And I always say that it used to be when people learned that I was on the FBI's 10 most wanted list, they sometimes reacted with horror. Oh God, who could she be? And nowadays, it gives you a sense of the impact of history. I mentioned it, and people applaud. it's wonderful to see you, and we are survivors. We are still here. And I would like to conclude by pointing out that as survivors, as elders, we have the responsibility to learn from the new generations as well. And I've been so excited this last period about the developments, the new organizations and movements, not only Black Lives Matter, hashtag Black Lives Matter, the organization Black Lives Matter, the movement Black Lives Matter, but other organizations like the Dream Defenders. I'm actually on the board of the Dream Defenders. Black Youth Project 100 out of Chicago, and the Justice League in New York, and the We Charge Genocide. And these are the people who are equivalent to the generation that would be our grandchildren. And it's so interesting to cultivate those relationships. In many societies, in African cultures, it's the grandparents who have the closest relationship with the children, not so much the parents, which isn't to say the parents don't matter. But I'm thinking about this in terms of the fact that there seems to be this new sense of the need to mobilize for justice among people of that generation. It gives me a great deal of hope, and I know that you and I have a great deal to learn from them. Thank you very much.
Thank you. all for coming tonight. There, for those of you who actually have a book in hand, there will be a small book signing up in the Mountain View Room. I know you all had your choice of political events this evening.